Welcome to today's live IELTS class. My name is Adrian, and I'm streaming to you from beautiful Budapest. I hope everybody has had a good week and is looking forward to an excellent weekend, staying healthy, staying strong. Students, in this class, we are looking at task one, writing specifically for a table. This is for the academic IELTS exam. And we are going to put together a band 9 example on this table today. And this lesson, everyone, is brought to you by aehelp.com. For academic IELTS success, please visit us there. And for general IELTS, check us out at gieltshelp.com. That's generalieltshelp.com. On both of our websites, we have loads and loads of fantastic materials for you to help improve your English, grammar, vocabulary, and your communication skills specifically for the IELTS. Our academic website looks like this with the blue background. Click that big red button to join the premium package. And the general version of our website has the same layout but with a green background at glshelp.com. Click that big red button. Hi, Abhishek. Hi, Janil. Welcome, members. This is a members chat class. Of course, everybody is welcome to watch. And for academic IELTS students, I highly recommend watching this class so you know what to do for a high band task one essay. In 90 minutes, we will continue and finish the task two essay that we started in the all chat class yesterday. So look forward to that. If you have questions about our courses or about the IELTS exam, don't hesitate to reach out to us. Just send me an email, adrian@aehelp.com, and I will gladly answer your inquiries. Tomorrow, we'll have more classes. We'll have speaking part two, speaking part three. Make sure to join for that. And for now, let's get into this task one writing. So here we go. You just finished the listening section and the reading section. You're about 2 hours into this exam. You're feeling good. You're feeling confident. And now you open up the writing section of your test. And this is what you see. So first step, let's read this together carefully. IELTS task one writing. You should spend about 20 minutes on this task. In the paper-based exam, they do not tell you when the 20 minutes is up, so keep an eye on the clock. There should be one in the room, or it's a good idea to wear a wristwatch if you have one. Make sure to spend only 20 minutes on this and spend 40 minutes on task two. They will tell you when the 1 hour is up because that will be the end of your sitting exam. Okay, so here we go with this question. The following table shows the sales of kiwi exports from New Zealand. Of course, New Zealand is a big exporter of that kiwi fruit to several countries for 3 specified years. Report the main features and make comparisons where relevant. Hi, Mustafa. Hi, Bekjan. Bekjan, I think you sent me this table question at some point. So here it is. Finally, you get to have a look at how we put it together. And then it says write at least 150 words. That means it's a minimum of 150 words. You have enough space on your exam paper for about 200-220 words. And indeed, as I keep mentioning, the higher band essays, band 7, 8, 9, they tend to be over that limit by about 25-30%. So closer to that 200 mark. Okay, so here's the question. We read it. Everybody knows what a kiwi is? Abhishek, Janil, Mustafa, Bekjan, we're all clear on what is a kiwi? Everybody's good on that? Yeah? Abhishek says, yeah, it's a fruit. Yeah, Abhishek, it is a fruit. Sure, yeah, it's that little, usually green on the inside, maybe brown on the outside. There's also that kind of sweet version of it that's more of like a yellow color. Okay. Baekjun, it's not the kiwi bird in this case. It's the fruit. But you're right, Baekjun. There is a type of bird called the kiwi bird. You're not completely off there. Yeah, black seeds. I'm pretty sure we're talking about the fruit in this case and not the birds. Okay, so the birds get to stay in New Zealand. Okay, I think they're in Australia as well, Baekjun. Okay, it's a delicious fruit, really high vitamin C content, actually. That's why it's popular. Delicious with a high vitamin C content. Okay, so it is kiwi that we're talking about, the kiwi exports from New Zealand. And now we take a look at this table. At first eye shot, it looks fairly simple. There's a good amount of information here for comparison. So right away, of course, we pay attention to the title, value, New Zealand sales of exports of kiwi from New Zealand in 2010 to 2012. Now, this is a little bit misleading because it's not really 2010 to 2012. It's more just in 3 years, 2010, 2011, and 2012. Fine, to these countries. And then here we have the countries, Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia. Okay, and then of course here we have the value in dollars. Now, I would assume that this is New Zealand dollar, but we don't need to name that, so that's okay. No need to worry about that. Okay, it could be US dollar, who knows. Okay, but it's dollar values nonetheless. So we take a look at this, and from this, we can start our overview. Okay, so for our overview, all we really need is the original question, as you know. Okay, so the table showing the sales of kiwis in New Zealand to several countries. And then we need to give more details. So, of course, we should mention the specific years, and we should mention maybe the specific countries. So that's the start of our table analysis, or of our table essay. We want to start with the overview here. So let's paraphrase this question and give it some detail to begin the overview. So do that now, members. I see a couple more of you have joined in, which is fantastic. I'm going to do the same, and then I'll give you some feedback and we'll compare. So, I believe that was six different countries. No, five. Five countries. Okay. Japan, Mexico, China, Russia, Saudi Arabia. Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia. And Saudi Arabia, of course, is often abbreviated as KSA, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. So I'm going to use that bracket KSA here because I want to avoid unnecessarily writing Saudi Arabia, Saudi Arabia, Saudi Arabia if I use that. So I'm going to show the reader right away here that Saudi Arabia in the remainder of this essay will be simplified to KSA, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Okay. So the provided table explains the revenue from kiwi exports in New Zealand to six different countries, or, yeah, two would be a bit better here, to six countries, namely Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia in the years 2010, 2011. And here I can be a little bit more specific as well in three consecutive years. Okay, consecutive meaning that they're coming right after one another. So three consecutive years. 2010, 2011, and 2012. So that's the paraphrase with the further detail to the original question. Okay, so notice the original question here one more time. The following table shows the sales of kiwi exports from New Zealand to several countries for three specified years. Report the main features and make comparisons where relevant. So what I did here is I gave more information for the three specified years, and I gave more information for several countries. Now, of course, that wasn't six. Make sure to have accurate information. In academic IELTS, it matters. It's five countries. So here we go. The provided table explains the revenue from kiwi exports in New Zealand to five countries, namely Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia, also known as KSA for the rest of this essay, in three consecutive years, 2010, 2011, and 2012. So that's your strong start there. Okay. All right, Beckjohn says, the given table depicts the amount of money generated by exporting kiwi fruits from New Zealand to five different countries, Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and UAE. UAE is not right, Beckjohn, careful. UAE is United Arabic Emirates. That's a different country or conglomerate of countries. So it's not the UAE here, Beckjohn. It's KSA, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Careful with that. Okay. In three consecutive years from 2010 to 2012, that works. Okay, Beckjohn, that's good. Abhishek says the given spreadsheet compares the trade of kiwi fruit exports from New Zealand to different countries, namely Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia, KSA, in 2010. 11 and 12. Good, Abhishek. Nicely done. Okay. All right. Mustafa says the given table illustrates New Zealand's kiwi sales overseas to a few countries in three consecutive years, 2011, 11 and 12. Mustafa, careful with your spelling and information. Okay. New Zealand, it's a country, capital N, capital Z. All right. Not shells or cells, but sales. Okay, sales, S-A-L-E-S, to a few countries, at least say to five countries. So name the number of countries, Mustafa, and careful with 2011 twice, all right? All of those would be counted against you, and you're losing marks. Now, you want to be really careful with this first sentence, students, because this first sentence is the first sentence of your entire writing section. If you make a lot of mistakes here, it will set the tone for your writing section. So be really careful with your overview. Okay, I've said that before, but I'm going to emphasize that one more time while I grab this beginning here. It's worth spending an extra minute on your overview, okay? Just to make sure it's as good as possible because it's your first impression for the marker for the quality of your writing, okay? So it is definitely worth proofreading your overview and making sure that it is absolutely accurate because it is the first paragraph of your writing section. The quality of your overview will set the tone for the marker for the rest of this section, okay? So if your overview is riddled with mistakes, it's gonna be really hard afterwards to convince that examiner, that marker, that you're good at writing and you deserve a band 7, 5, 8, 9, okay? It's hard to do that if you have a bad first impression, so keep it in mind, all right? Dr. Krishna says, hello, sir. Sorry to interrupt. I just returned from my speaking test. It went well. My topic for part two was talk about a meal you had with your friends. That sounds like an interesting topic. So it was an object, right, Dr. Krishna? I hope that you recognized it was an object. So you needed to talk about its appearance, what it looks like, what it tastes like in this case, its origin, who made it, the amazing cooks at the kitchen where you were, or parents or something, right? So the origin, its meaning to you. So hopefully you recognize that that was an object, Dr. Krishna. Thank you for sharing that. Devyani, welcome to the class as well. Good to see more members jumping in at the beginning of the essay here. So now we want to add the main feature, right? That's the next step. Adding the main feature, this is all still part of the overview. You do not need to separate these into different paragraphs. There's zero point in doing that. In fact, it just reads better when the main feature is together with the paraphrase and details, okay? Yeah, Dr. Krishna, definitely let us know what you got when you get your score, okay? All right, so here we go. Let's take a look at this table again and observe the main feature. What is the most observable main feature? And please, please, please do not tell me the most and the least. I do not want you to be the 9 of 10 students here. I want you to be the one clever student who looks beyond the most and the least. So don't tell me about the most and the least. I don't care about that right now. I think there's another main feature that's much more interesting for me anyway. Okay, so what is that main feature? What do we notice beyond the most and the least? Okay, most and the least, they're obvious, right? It's almost hierarchical if you go from top to bottom, so it's fine. But we can see more than that. Okay, if we go from top to bottom, left to right, okay, you're always going top to bottom, left to right, you'll actually see some more interesting information. So Mustafa says increased, not expenditure, Mustafa, but increased revenue for each country except for Saudi Arabia. I don't know about that. Careful, Mustafa, because take a look, Mustafa, at Mexico. 6 million, 2.4 million, 3 million, right? So I don't think that's quite true. All right, so careful. Almost, though, you're kind of on the right track, Mustafa. Okay. That's not, so looking at the form of the table, Devyani, it's not really important. So seeing that it goes from Japan, which is the most, to Saudi Arabia, which is the least, it's not so important. That's just the form of the table. We could give that in lots of other ways as well. Okay. What do we notice? Okay, so here we have increases, here we have increases, here we have decrease, increase, here we have increase, here we have decrease, here we have lots and lots of revenue, here we have little revenue. So what can we say? Don't overthink it, okay? Don't overthink it, all right? Think about if you work in the kiwi stock market in New Zealand, what is kind of the more general main feature that's interesting for you here? Okay. Okay, so let me start and then see if you agree with me here. Okay. Again, this takes a bit of practice, but you'll get this. So definitely look beyond just the most and the least. Okay. So looking at this spreadsheet, generally, it can be noted that there is great, or there is significant differences in kiwi sales, not only among countries, but also within countries in the given years. Okay, so again, don't overthink it. Hema Bhandari, welcome to our group of members. Make sure to send me an email so I can hook you up with your exclusive videos, okay? Yeah, so Baekjeon, there you go. So Baekjeon got it kind of at the same time. Yeah, so Hassan got it too. Very good, Hassan. Very good, Baekjeon. Both of you got it. You get the double thumbs up. Baekjeon, you can take the left. Hassan, you can take the right. No, just kidding. Grab them both. All right. But you got it. That's it. So just generally speaking, when we look at this table, we can see that there's a lot of variance within the countries. So there's quite big jumps, right? I mean, if we look at 2010 to 2012, it's a difference of $34 million in kiwi exports. That's a lot of kiwi, $34 million worth of kiwi to Japan, okay? And then we can see that in other countries as well. Whether it's up or down doesn't quite matter at this point. It just matters that there's a lot of variance. They're not the same amounts, okay? And then, of course, we can see a wide range of variance in the amounts when we compare among these countries. So Saudi Arabia is just a fraction of Japan, and we can see those. So we'll talk about those in more detail once we get into the analyses component. But for right now, for the overview, we just want to tell our reader that, hey, we looked at this table, and we can see that there's a lot of variance within each country and among these countries for the given years. Does that make sense? Everybody's got that? So that's what you want to tell your reader, okay? Remember, always think that the reader is not looking at the table. You're telling your reader this information in such a way as if they are not looking at this information, okay? So now we can go into the analysis. Or the analyses. Analyses, of course, is plural. And for the analyses, we want to indicate 6 to 8 points, right? So note 6 to 8 points for report. And do that before, okay? So do it before you begin writing. Okay, so let's do that. Let's take a look at this table. Let's indicate our points, all right? Okay, what should be our first point? So give me some points here, students. So what should be my first point of comparison? What should be my second point? Just give it to me. And I'm going to state it. Let's see if you're thinking the same. So clearly, when we look at this in detail, Japan would be my first point. Now, what do I say in that first point, right? Because obviously it's the most, okay? And it's so much more than the others that it's more than three times or almost four times the second importer of kiwi from New Zealand, which is China, right? So it's a multiple of three to four times more than China. And if we add together all of the other four countries, it's still only a fraction of Japan, right? So even if we sum all of these countries together, right? Yeah, Baekjeon, you can sum here. So there's some interesting summation. Absolutely. It's exactly what I'm talking about right now. So even when we sum these countries together, we only come up with a fraction of the dollar value of Japan's kiwi imports from New Zealand. So, par none, Japan is the number one customer out of these countries for New Zealand's kiwi supply. Okay. So that's definitely our point number one. That's what we want to write about. And clearly China is number two. Okay. Because after China, we get into a fraction of what China is, right? So Mexico at 6 million is less than one-tenth here, right? So it's a 10-time multiplier, or you could say Mexico is a tenth, one-tenth of China. And this is pretty much applicable to every year, okay? So these great differences, they exist in all three of the years given, okay? So Japan is hundreds of millions of dollars. China is tens of millions of dollars. Mexico is millions of dollars. And then once you get into Russia and Saudi Arabia, you're in at either millions or hundreds of thousands of dollars, right? So that's what we're looking at here. So Mexico would be maybe number three. And then Russia and Saudi Arabia, I would group as 4 or 5. So maybe emphasizing that Saudi Arabia or KSA is much, much less. Okay. And then for my sixth point, now this is an important point, so I'd make sure I have enough time to get that in there. I would state the countries that increased their imports, okay? So significantly, especially Japan, Russia, and China. And then for seventh, you might want to go with these points here, okay? Where it's a change in Mexico where they're at 6 million and then less than half and then a slight increase in 2012. And then Saudi Arabia, which is less than half a year later and again less the following year. So that's what we want to focus on here. Yeah. Yeah, you can. So Baek-chan, that summation, you know where it would be really good if you're writing quickly and you're staying ahead of the curve? I would probably include the sum of sales, the average sum of sales, so whatever we come up with here, the number, I think that's what you're looking for here. So I would put that maybe somewhere in the summary, okay? I think that would be a very good one for a summary. I would love to see that if I'm dealing with kiwi stocks and kiwi exports in New Zealand, to have that as a summary. What were the overall sales to these five countries in the 3 years? Okay. But again, make sure you have time for it and put that into the summary. All right. So let's go step by step. Let's discuss Japan. All right. So emphasizing the importance of Japan in the kiwi industry for New Zealand. Go ahead, begin your sentences. Take this extra bit of time while I clean the board and report on Japan. So 71 million, 87 million, 325 million. Okay. And the difference between Japan and the other five countries. Okay. So. Hema, just send me an email later on, okay? So send me an email later on. All right, so here we go. I'm going to start the analysis as well with Japan. Okay. So looking at the table in more detail, it is evident that Japan is by far the largest market of these countries for kiwi imports from New Zealand. Now, New Zealand, I might write several times as well, so I'm going to do the NZ. And if you're in the computer-based exam, this will be an easy fix. If not, then you're going to have to kind of sneak it in in the paper-based exam, so I would do NZ here as well. So definitely abbreviate countries that have multiple words like this, just so that you don't waste a lot of time writing New Zealand over and over again in your essay, okay? So looking at the table in more detail, it is evident that Japan is by far the largest market of these countries for kiwi imports from New Zealand, with over $250 million in imports for 2010, which was nearly four times greater than second place Russia. Okay, Japan continued to import more kiwi, or continued to spend more on kiwi. We don't know if it's more kiwi because maybe prices increased. Continued to spend more on kiwi in the coming years. By 2012, this number is or was over $325 million. And of course, I'm going to use the symbol for that. Okay, $1 million. So use symbols for words like dollars and percents. Again, don't waste time writing out the word dollars or percents. Use the symbol. Time is valuable in the IELTS exam. In fact, it's very valuable. So you want to maximize your use of time, your efficiency, your use of time, okay? All right. Hassan says, in 2010, Japan bought from New Zealand three times the amount of China. Yeah, sorry, you're right, Hassan. It's China, not Russia. Let me correct that again. Information matters. Yeah, you're on the right track. Thanks for that, Hassan. Kiwi imports at around $270 million. Good. So kind of synonymous with mine, right, Hassan? So I said, looking at the table in more detail, it is evident that Japan is by far the largest market of these countries for kiwi imports from New Zealand, with over $250 million in imports for 2010. Which was nearly four times greater than second place China. Japan continued to spend more on kiwi in the coming years. By 2012, this number was over $325 million. Okay, go for it, Abhishek. I hope you have a great meeting. All right. Nice writing, students. Nice writing. All right. So, Baekjeon says, when looking at the table in more detail, it becomes clear that Japan purchased a large part of New Zealand's kiwi fruit market, which increased over the years from $271 to $325 million. And these numbers are four times greater than second place China. So I would add, Baekjeon, second place China. Okay. Mustafa says, at first glance, it is clear that Japan had the highest revenue generated out of the five countries, with roughly the highest revenue generated for New Zealand. Mustafa, that's a very important missing subject there, for New Zealand. Out of the five countries, with roughly $250 million in imports for 2010, whereas China came in second place. Yeah, good. Okay, capital C on China. Dr. Krishna says, Overall, Dr. Krishna, not over here, overall, it seems like the approximate summation of the other four countries is equivalent to the yield from Japan with $270 million in 2010. I'm not sure what summation you're doing there, Dr. Krishna, so you have to be a little bit careful. I think you might mean like summing not only the countries, but all the years as well, right? So that's a bit of an awkward perspective, I think. I don't know if I'd go down that road, Dr. Krishna, but I get what you're saying. So basically, you're summing all of these sales and comparing it just to 2010 for Japan. I think that's a bit of an awkward look, but yeah, it works, okay? All right, so next is China, followed by Mexico, right? So 74, 84, 94. So here we have a fairly consistent, roughly 10 million increase each year, okay, which is pretty nice. So let's talk about that, and then we can go on into Mexico, okay? All right, like Japan, China also spent more on kiwi, and we can say New Zealand kiwi, New Zealand kiwi, each of these years by approximately 10 million more in 2011 and again in 2012. Okay. And let's not forget that dollar sign. So there we go. That's Russia, or sorry, China for us. I don't know why I keep saying Russia. So like Japan, China also spent. Now, this like Japan is a really important connective here, all right? Your goal in Task 1, members, is always to show similarities and differences. And when you show a similarity, you want to emphasize that. Okay, so you want to emphasize that similarity. So like Japan, China also spent more on New Zealand kiwi each of these years by approximately $10 million more in 2010 and again in 2012. All right? Okay. So now we can go on to Mexico. And if I feel like I'm writing a lot here, so let's take a peek at how many words I have so far, and you should test this at home. So this is about 89 words, okay, just the analysis so far. If I combine that with my overview, let me just actually take out the instructional part here. Okay, So far, I have 151 words. So my overview and my analysis so far is 151 words. So at this point, I have to be really careful and I have to be very conscious of how fast am I writing? How much time do I have? Do I still have 5 minutes left, 10 minutes left? This is what you need to practice at home so that you can decide how much more information and detail to include. As you can probably see, even though this table looks simple, you could probably write a 500 word report on this, no problem, but you don't have time or space for that. So you have to be selective, okay? That's why the question says the main features, okay? So now, if I want to be clever here, I'm going to combine these last three countries a little bit so that I can leave space for some more important information. Okay, all right. I see that meanwhile, Hassan and Baekjun have come up with the next parts as well. So Hassan says, the second place for kiwi imports from New Zealand is China, starting at 74 million in 2010, followed by nearly 10 million increase in 2011 and 2012. Good. So we're interpreting, right? We're not just reporting numbers, but we're interpreting. That's what you have to do for band 7, 8, 9 essays. You have to interpret the information. You have to do more than just report the information. Okay, so good for you. You're on the right track. All right, so here I can say that Mexico, where are my other countries? So Mexico, Saudi Arabia, and Russia, right? So Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia spent much less on kiwi than China or Japan. Roughly. One tenth that of China for Mexico, and just $1 million or less for Russia and KSA. All right. So what I'm doing here is I'm trying to condense this information because I'm already at 150 words and I know that I should be maxing out at around 200. So I really want to condense this interpretation as much as possible. So Mexico, Russia, and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia spent much less, not much less in, much less on. This is where spaces are important. Much less on kiwi than China or Japan. Roughly one tenth that of China for Mexico, and just $1 million or less for Russia and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Also, it is worth noting that, and I think somebody said this, that in the beginning, that Japan, China, and Russia spent more each year, while Mexico and Saudi Arabia decreased spending. Okay, I'm not going to worry about this small difference here. I'm just going to say decreased. Okay, so that's all I'm going to say here. All right. So, also, it is worth noting that Japan, China, and Russia spent more money on kiwi each year, as where Mexico and decreased their spending from 2010. Okay. Now, depending on my time, I could have done that for my summary as well. Okay. So, everybody paying attention, members? So, I could have said this as also, in summary, it is also worth noting that Japan. Okay. But here, I decided to add this still because let's see, I realized I still have about 5 minutes left in my task one. So I'm going to do a really good band nine here and save my summary for that summation, okay? So in summary, when summing up the columns, especially as a result of Japan's and China's increased spending, New Zealand kiwi sales improved by roughly. Okay, and then this is where I would do that quick summation if I still have a couple minutes left. So here I'm just looking at how much more money is being gained. So little bit of losses here, but overall we have a plus 10 million and a plus 15 million here. Take away this difference here. So a roughly $20 million dollar revenue increase here. And then here, so again, it doesn't have to be a perfect number, students. It just has to be an approximate. Okay, so 20 million. And then here, from 2011 to 2012, we have a solid, let's see, 20, 40, 50, 50, 50, let's say roughly 45, okay, just to be on the safe side. All right, so 45 million increase, okay, roughly. So again, doesn't have to be perfect. So that's what I would say, okay? So in summary, when, and I don't want to use summing here because it's similar to summary, when adding up the columns, especially as a result of Japan's and China's increased spending, New Zealand's kiwi sales improved by roughly 20 million dollars from 2010 to 2011. And by 45 million from 2011 to 2012. Okay, so that's your Band 9 essay, everyone. Now, of course, you don't have to have this exact information and writing, but if you're wondering what a Band 9 essay looks like, an analysis looks like, which means an expert user of the English language, and in the academic IELTS, that also means an expert analysis and expository essay, then it would look something like this, okay? It's not the only way. There are other ways, but this is the level of analysis that is expected and level of language that is expected for a Band 9, okay? So let's read this together. The provided table explains the revenue from kiwi exports in New Zealand to five countries, namely Japan, China, Mexico, Russia, and Saudi Arabia, in three consecutive years, 2010, 11, and 12. Looking at this spreadsheet, generally, it can be noted that there are significant differences in kiwi sales, not only among countries, but also within countries in the given years. Looking at the table in more detail, it is evident that Japan is by far the largest market of these countries for kiwi imports from New Zealand, with over $250 million in imports for 2010, which was nearly four times greater than second place China. Japan continued to spend more on kiwi in the coming years. By 2010, this number was over $325 million. Like Japan, China also spent more on New Zealand kiwi each of these years by approximately 10 million more in 2011 and again in 2012. Mexico, Russia, and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia spent much less on kiwi than China or Japan, roughly one-tenth that of China for Mexico, and just $1 million or less for Russia and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Also, it is worth noting that Japan, China, and Russia spent more money on kiwi each year, as where Mexico and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia decreased their spending from 2010. In summary, when adding up the columns, especially as a result of Japan and China's increased spending, New Zealand kiwi sales improved roughly by $20 million from 2010 to 2011, and by $45 million dollars from 2011 to 2012. And that's about 210 words total, 215 maybe max. And that would be your Band 9 essay. Okay. And I can see that Bekjan and Hassan wrote some more sentences as well. Those are some good sentences. Students, even when I don't read your sentences, it's great practice. So keep doing that. Okay. Don't just write if I read. Make sure to keep writing. It's for you. You're doing a good job. All right. Fantastic. So that's it for this essay. I'm glad I was able to share this with you. Thank you, Bekjan, for sending this table a few weeks back. I'm happy we finally got to it. It's a nice example. I believe it was a part of a past exam. Okay. And now we will continue with task two in 30 minutes to finish yesterday's essay. Okay. You're very welcome, Bekjan. For all of those watching, make sure to check us out at aehelp.com for lots more examples, videos, practice tests, students for speaking, and so on. For general IELTS, it's gieltshelp.com. Check us out there. Join the premium package. You're very welcome, Janil. You're very welcome, Hassan. Have a fantastic break, and hopefully I will see most of you, or even all of you, in 30 minutes for finishing task 2 at a band 9 level. Bye for now, everyone. I'm Adrian, signing out. See you shortly.